Yeah, this recording.
Yeah,
the
Gregster.
The Gregster reminded me of something I saw online. Somebody posted this video of this girl. Seems like a high school chick. I don't know. And she's talking to her buddy, her boyfriend or ex-boyfriend Matt, right into the video camera. And I guess he broke up with her. And she's saying how he's missing out, and she wants to show Matt her sexual side. And she starts taking her clothes off. And she gets completely naked, puts the camera down by her gash, and starts plunging her fingers in a very unsexy fashion, and saying how she'll do anything for him. Begging. Psycho chick. And this is like psycho guy.
Well, why can't we get that audio on the show?
I know,
today?
We gotta get that audio.
Why can't we get that video to yellowtreats@AOL.com?
Oh, it's on Whackbag.
Well, if it's on Whackbag, can we get the audio, Eric, right away?
Yes.
By the way, real fast, Anthony, someone needs to email the link to Steve or Eric, that video you were talking about.
Yeah. I'm not sure if it's illegal or not, so I don't know.
Oh.
Yeah. I'm sure the audio of it would be really good to get, but... Oh, they pulled it off the site?
Not up there.
That's not on the site? That means
I've heard rumor that she isn't underage, that she is. Who knows, but...
Always better to be safe than sorry.
That's right.
That's what I say, Esther.
Well, well, that just woke Jimmy up.
Yeah.
Jimmy saw ticket sales plummeting and merchandising going down. God, Jimmy was laid back nice, just relaxing, reading the paper, dreaming about his coffee that's about to arrive any moment, and that piped you right back up. You're sitting straight up again. Yeah, we should just leave that alone. We do want this job for a while.
Yeah, pull the audio off of it, though. Pretty cool.
Okay.
Can't get in trouble for the audio.
How do you know?
I don't.
Well, it's audio you're playing. I mean, if you're playing it as a news thing, you're not. We don't know anything about it.
First of all, I've never heard of anyone getting in trouble, like as far as criminal charges for playing audio,
right,
of any type of illegal pornography. You know, I've never heard of that. Anyone? Anyone? You ever hear of a bust go down because audio was being played?
Lobster?
Ah, let's go for it.
Back in the olden days, I remember one time we were listening to some illegal pornography audio on the Victrola.
Yeah.
And some revenuers came running in and bashed everything apart with sledgehammers.
What the hell's a revenuer?
I don't know. Just something they did in black and white times.
The tax man shows up with a hat and a suit.
They hit our still with an axe and left us broke. All we had was the whiskey left in the bathtub.
Don, what's up?
Hey, man.
Hey.
The minute I heard that, you know what I started thinking of? Do you remember the tapes from the MyPsychoExGirlfriend.com? That guy?
Yeah.
These guys would make a perfect couple for each other, man.
Yeah, that was one with Psycho Bitch.
Is that audio still out there?
Gotta be.
It's gotta be on OA Virus, man.
Well, someone find that audio for us. We, you know, for the new listeners, you got to hear this psycho girlfriend.
Oh, you just want to kill her.
Can we find that, Steve or somebody? All right, we're looking for it. All right.
All right, guys, welcome back. Punching out.
Thanks, Don. So we have the audio of that girl. Where is it, though?
Oh, cool.
Steve's still coming with it.
Steve?
Steve's got it?
I thought he had it.
I thought he had it,
I thought
it
he
too.
Said he had it.
That goddamn Steve is full
Steve.
Of shit.
Steve? Oh, you had it, Steve.
We're dying in here,
he's just
Steve.
In there.
Big, smooth, shaved arms with tattoos on them.
Tattoos?
What?
Where's that audio, Steve?
It's right there. I just gave it to you.
Oh, boy.
Eric, I never saw it. Right,
what is that?
What is it, Hawk, for Christ's sake?
Come on, Eric.
Eric needs to sleep more.
Open your eyes.
You really need to sleep
you
more, Eric.
You certainly do.
I was right in front of you.
It was right under your nose.
Never saw it.
God, this is a really long thing.
How long is it, Ope?
Yeah, she kind of goes on.
A couple hours?
What's the deal with this chick?
Piece of it.
What do we know about this girl?
Well, we don't know much, but what I'm finding out very slowly is that apparently this chick killed herself after this video was released.
This
I don't know.
Urban legend.
I don't know. I'm trying to...
Dude. I swear, she killed herself, dude. I've heard all kinds of stories. She had to change schools. She killed herself. No one's got an answer, though.
No, unfortunately,
girl,
I can't find any proof.
She appears to be in high school, but who knows? There's other things like her. I've heard she's really young, but no, her body, believe me, is that of a woman.
Yes.
And she's talking about this guy, Matt, and how she wants to get with Matt.
They didn't have bodies like that when we were going to high school. God, if I hear one more person say that.
Oh.
They were saying that on the news the other day. We all get it. The girls are hotter in high school than when we were growing up.
Well, they didn't dress like that when I... Yeah.
Exactly.
How
many times have you heard that?
You see a black guy walking. Wow, we didn't have them in the hallways when I was in school. Yeah. All right, your awful 50 stories. No one gives a shit.
Me and Groucho were talking. He brought up the same thing.
Well, it's funny.
Girls like that.
When Jane Mansfield got decapitated, people were going, they didn't have heads like that when I was in school, being held up under the fucking wreckage of a trailer.
any Jane Mansfield's head reference, I enjoy.
Oh, you have to.
Yeah, you were all over the road.
Dude,
just like
I was just riding, looking for something with Mansfield in it. They didn't have heads like that. What did that mean? Of course they did. No one ever said that either. So I just lied for a cheap decapitation joke.
it was a joy, though.
Of course.
So we'll just play this audio and see what happens, I guess, huh?
Yeah, give a listen. It's some girl trying to get Matt to either take her back or go out with her. I think take her back. So she shows her sexual side, and what you'll hear is audio of her talking to Matt as she takes her clothes off and then diddles herself.
Now, if a girl does this for you, what are you thinking? Obviously, that you're going to have some really good sex in the near future, but as far as a long-term plan, what's going on in your head? Are you thinking psycho broad?
But if you're in high school, if you're in high school, you run. You run. Dick first, you run. As fast as you can. Right towards this.
Oh, we got more info on the girl, Anthony.
Oh, I'm sure. It's
from
all
the video?
Accurate.
Yeah, of course it is. Mike in Jersey.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey.
Hey, you guys were wondering what happened with that girl on the video.
Uh-huh.
I heard she ate Pop Rocks and drank Pepsi. She fucking blew up.
Wow.
If you agree with me, just hang up.
Very good.
He hung up on himself.
He did.
All right, here's the audio.
Matt, you don't understand how much I like you. I know you think I like you a lot, but that's only the half of it. And I know you really don't want a girlfriend right now, but you have to think of what you're putting me through, too. If I can put up with you and all your shit for this long, I'm obviously going to stay with you forever. So, I really just want to let you know what you're missing out on. So, here's a little bit of my sexual side.
Wow, is she naked?
No, right now she's dressed. She's got like kind of a little top thing on that's showing her belly. Ooh. And she's wearing a jacket, some kind of jacket over it, and pants.
She sounds young, man.
So then she is in front of the camera and starts doing things.
Big boobies?
Nice size.
Braces?
No.
No pigtails?
No. No pigtail. Blonde hair.
Okay.
There's the cleavage I don't have. There's the boobs I kind of have.
And a bra.
Here's my nice stomach.
Takes her shirt off. She's in her bra and pants.
Again. Now I'm putting
Takes her bra off.
It's hard to hear. What's going on?
Yeah, she's kind of away from the camera.
Okay.
She kind of walked back, so she's completely in frame. And she takes her shirt off, and she's in her bra, and she's dancing around, and then she danced around a little more and takes her bra off. Goes back to the camera, takes her pants off, takes her panties off, and then takes her fingers and starts doing things to herself.
Saucy.
I'm going to give all the just because it won't go over. Well, I think it'd be a little bit stupid to get that. Don't you? But,
she gets back up.
It's all up to you.
It's all up to you, Matt. This could be yours.
With, up to you. And no matter what you decide that, I will always understand. Because I'm that kind of person who can just go with the flow. And I never will underestimate you or your decision for whatever you pick. Now, Matt.
All right, is she back? Now what's going on here?
Now she's back. She tilts the camera down to her lap area, and she's taking fingers and doing
so
things to herself.
So she's back in range so we can hear her.
Yeah, yeah, and now she starts doing herself and telling Matt, you know, that this could all be his.
So what we just heard was her kind of in the background
dancing,
showing off her body,
yeah,
and stuff.
Like full frame.
Everyone is screaming, where is the video, where is the video, where is the video?
I have no idea.
I've never seen it, actually.
Good luck finding it, and good luck with the federal authorities if you do
find
it.
She sounds like a young man. She sounds young.
Here's something that I know you want to see.
Camera's on her lap.
You've been waiting for that for a long time, haven't you, Matt? You can have it all. The whole package. All you have to do is ask.
She's getting a little worked up.
And I will understand whatever you pick. Because I love you, Matt. And you'd be a fool to give this up. Because no matter how hard you try, you know, you can't just give up on me. Because deep down inside, in your little twisted head, you love me. You're just afraid to admit it. Because you don't know what's going to happen to you if you tell the world how you feel about me. Just do it, Matt.
It's the Gregster's phone number.
I was just
going right
to say
now.
That.
Because I know you want to. You want to so bad.
Can you hear it?
It kills you.
All right, now what?
I don't know, but I think it's pretty hot.
That's pretty much what she's doing. And then she, you know, puts the video back up and dance around. And then at some point she goes to a door jam. And straddles, like puts her leg up on the door jamb and starts licking the door jamb and saying that could be Matt.
She wants Matt.
Kinda hung up.
She likes really this Maddie the Moocher, doesn't she?
Yeah. She's kind of hung up on it.
Let me, want to try a little more of the audio?
The video's out. It's on the internet somewhere, you know? It's just a matter of finding it. And
well, a lot of people are saying if you Google and type in Psycho Girl Matt.
Really?
There'll be a bunch of links.
Really?
For that's what I'm hearing. That's what I'm hearing, Anthony.
All of this. It really does kill you.
Naked at this point?
Yeah.
Now, let me show you.
Getting on the door jam.
I'm pressing against Matt.
Now, what is she doing? Working the door jam?
Yeah, making believe she's pressing against Matt.
Or it could be you and some ugly fat chick that won't do anything for you. But me, on the other hand, I'll do anything you ask. All you have to do is be nice, and you've got it. And that, I just wanted to let you know what you were missing out on. And if you decide you want to change your mind about anything, just let me know. Because I'll be here. And I totally, utterly understand anything. Tell me. And no matter how much you put me through, I still love you. No matter how hard I try to forget about you, you're still on my mind. Forever and always. So, just... Hey, Matt. Don't give up. Don't give up too easily. Because, I don't
want to
lose you. Bye, Matt. I love you.
Ah, and there you have it.
Yeah.
And there's the video. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
It's funny. I was talking to Eric Logan about this.
Yeah.
And Eric said, you know what? She's making a play for Matt.
Yeah. I think she is.
Wow. The video is ridiculous. That's all I have to say.
I saw a picture of her face, and I haven't seen the video, but the picture of her face, she looks 18. I mean, she doesn't look young. She sounds young, but she looks like the whole thing's probably a fake.
She looks like she could be 18.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I absolutely would.
Yeah.
Right.
I wouldn't worry about it.
Matt's a dope.
Matt's an idiot.
Hope Matt right now is hanging himself.
I love this Matt guy because you know it was him that put it on the internet. It's true.
It's got to be, right?
Yeah.
All right, Anthony.
Check instant feedback. There's other links on here that say, Psycho Girl. All right, that's the same thing. I thought it was a audio of an.
Dude, it's easy. You can get it. What you do is you go to eatabullet.com, uh-huh. And you go under whoring myself merchandise, and there's like a bunch of like things for sale like that.
Hmm.
All right. We can't find the... Psycho ex-girlfriend stuff, huh?
Nah, that's good stuff, though.
That stuff is gone, unless someone has it out there and they can send it to us. A little homework assignment for some of the faithful listeners. That was a great, great website. A girl that just losing her mind over and over again for this guy on his answer machine, and the guy being just a scumbag.
Oh, yeah. And
made a website.
Insane. She just loses it.
There's like, what, 20 or 30? No, I think it's like, it just goes on and on and on, right?
She doesn't stop calling.
All right.
Nut.
How many messages?
Just, I forget. I mean, there was just...
Maybe 50.
There could easily be 50.
One nuttier
just
than
losing
the last.
Her mind, threatening him, and all sorts of crazy stuff.
You gotta love that guy, though. What a great sight.
Yeah. All right, we got some clips from Psycho Ex-Girlfriend.
All right.
I want to thank somebody for sending this in to us. Was it Dan from Hoboken?
Yeah, that was one of the people that said they were sending in.
Well, thanks for helping out the show. Basically, this was from a website. Mm-hmm. And this guy took all the voicemails from his ex-girlfriend, psycho ex-girlfriend, and put them up on the website for everyone else's listening pleasure, mm-hmm. Anthony. So we could get through a few of these. I have 50.
50?
And some no one has because he got a cease and desist and had to take off some really, really rank ones, I guess.
Oh.
But we still have a fine sample of calls from this ex-girlfriend.
Here, this
lunatic. No new messages. Saved messages. Saturday, February 3rd, 9:09 p.m.
You better fucking call me back on my cell phone. I'm done doing this thing with you, chasing you, until the part where you'd exhaust me. Well, you have already. What the fuck are you doing? So do you really want it to be over? Is that what you want? Are you going to be a happy boy then? No, I guess so. That's what you told me. So I guess I should just listen to that. Call me back, Mark. You better call me soon, because I'm done chasing you. I can't express this to you enough. You know, sometimes you only do this so many times, and then it just becomes fucking old, doesn't it?
That's that one.
All right.
Oh, we're just warming
Sounds
up.
Sounds a little angry.
I love that we can play these uncensored. The beauty of satellite radio.
Back in the old days. Beep, beep.
Yuck. But according to Rolling Stone magazine, the beauty of satellite radio is shock jocks Opie and Anthony can curse all they want on the radio these days.
Yeah,
that's about all you get from satellite radio.
What do you expect from that dumb magazine? They haven't written a relevant thing in 30 years.
I enjoy the Rolling Stone, actually.
I never liked it.
I still
it.
Enjoy the Rolling Stone.
If
awful.
They, if they put Sabbath on the cover.
Yeah, but they wouldn't. Why would they? What does Ozzy win an award for fighting a bat? You predictable faggots. You fucking left-wing political ideology, consistently boring.
The loyal loyalty.
It's just awful.
All right, here's another clip.
Saved message. Saturday, February 3rd, 9:12 p.m.
Hear this. I know you're checking your messages, I can tell. Right now it's 10 after 9, and since now you've tortured me all day and night, you better fucking call me back, Mark. You better fucking call me back. If you want any chance of ever working this out with me, I swear to God, I've done every fucking thing that I can possibly do. So are you happy? Are you happy? Did you just go out there and booze it up on your own? Okay? Because I came over to see you and you denied seeing me again.
Okay!
Again. And I was even coming over to you after apologizing to you, after doing all those things, saying all those things on the phone to you that mean absolutely fucking nothing. So I hope you're happy. I hope you're happy being a lonely guy.
Well,
oh, but wait. What? I know you got a lot of dates, so maybe you won't be that lonely.
Well,
you know what? I've done everything I fucking can. You want to be with me? Yeah. Great. Yeah, you want to be with me. Thanks for showing me.
I think she's hurt.
Can we play this message?
Well, I talked to Eric Logan, and he seems to think that she's trying to get back with this guy.
What was his quote again? Because that was way in the beginning of the show.
Oh, it's it was amazing. He picked this thing out.
This is from the Rolling Stone. We've been talking about the Rolling Stone article on satellite radio off and on this morning, and our big boss is quoted as well.
That one.
You thought we had a great quote.
Dude, Logan gets right to the meat of the issue.
He says, if you have a hit-driven channel, people are going to hang out there.
Boom, there.
There you go.
Yeah.
He should call in and defend himself.
What? No, against what? He made the right statement.
Here's another.
Do you know what year these are, by the way?
This goes back a few years now. We played them about 4 years ago.
Saved message. Saturday, February 3rd, 9:15 p.m.
All I can say is, if you're out at a fucking bar.
Uh-oh.
When I went to your house, drove by you. You saw me, and you just drove by me, and I called you to apologize, to tell you how much I meant to you, how much you meant to me. If you're at a fucking bar right now, I will never, ever forgive you, ever. Because if you could be having a good time, then you know what? Fuck you. And you know what? You're right. Then I need to move on. But I hope you know what you're doing. Because I'm not fucking playing around anymore. You know, what do you think? The world is going to fucking chase you forever, Mark? That, you know what? Everybody's going to fucking chase you because you're Mr. Wonderful? Yeah. Well, you got some flaws going on yourself. So you know what? When I call you and apologize, they call you a million times to tell you how much you mean to me. That should mean something, but obviously it doesn't. So you fucking have a good time out at a fucking bar, but I'll tell you what. If you're there, don't ever fucking call me again.
She laid down the law.
To replay this message.
It's amazing what people will say in grief. Just what idiots people become. If you think the whole world's just going to run around chasing you forever. What? He didn't say that. He's just in a bar drinking, trying to get away from you.
Yeah. That's the third call. There's 50 of these.
Saved message. Saturday, February 3rd, 9:29 p.m.
Well, you won. Not only have you ruined my day, but you've ruined my night. Because I'm too upset to even think about going out to have fun. Fun? want to be with you, and I want to be with someone who doesn't want to be with me. So, yeah, that would be a real good time out tonight, huh? Anyway, I know that I got to move on, and I'm going to, and mark my words, if I don't hear from you shortly, I'm moving on, because I'm not going to play this game tomorrow. And I know I keep saying that, and I know I keep calling you back, but it's fucking draining, Mark, and I'm tired of it. And I've chased after you once again all fucking day and all fucking night. So you know what? Have fun with your fucking stubbornness. And you know what? I hope the next fucking woman that you date, or girl, maybe I should say, puts up with your stubbornness, because I can't deal with it. I've given you everything. I've said to you every possible thing that I could say. I basically came crawling back, even though, you know what? It's not only my fault. It's us. And, you know what? You continue to fucking torture me, and I just hope that you're really having a good time. And I know you're probably not, so whatever. I hope you got what you wanted from all this, because it's just fucking sad. So I'm moving on. I'm going to bed, and I am certainly moving on tomorrow morning. Goodbye.
All right. Well, she's moving on. That's good.
She's moving on. That is nice.
These dignity salvaging things people try to say. Oh. Like, hey, you know what? I don't care. I'm going to bed. I'm moving on. Come 2004. It's done.
Right. I showed you.
But she didn't go to bed.
No.
Sage message. Wednesday, February 7th, 8:39 p.m.
You know, and that was my biggest fear, doing this phone thing. Because, you know, I was trying to do it on good faith, knowing that you'd help me with it and you'd make a priority and, you know, it would be okay regardless. And it's not. And my cell phone's disconnected as of tomorrow, and I need to call AT&T right now to reinstate my cell phone. And I guess I'm fucked again. Because you know what? I put faith in this, us, and you helping me out with this. And I'm not going to listen to you over voicemail how to set up my mailbox. There's a lot of other things on this stupid phone that I don't even know how to operate. So I'm paying for something I don't even know how to use. So can you do me a favor and let me know what to do with this thing? I don't know. And I'm not trying to be a prick, but you know what? I don't know what to do. I have no cell phone as of tomorrow because I trust in you.
Wow.
Wow. She's taking another tack.
To replay this.
Like, well, now you got to call me because I got a problem with my cell phone.
Yeah, look, and I don't want to discuss the relationship right. or anything, but this cell phone.
Right, but you're the only one that can help me with my cell phone.
I don't have a phone because I trusted you. Because
I trusted you.
What, did he throw it out the car window or something?
You said you loved me and now I have roaming charges.
Jesus.
Stage message. Wednesday, February 7th, 9:34 p.m.
I'm going to the hospital because I... I'm going to the hospital and you don't fucking care.
Wow.
You got a fucking prove a point. I hope you're fucking happy.
All over a cell phone?
To replay this message, press 1.
Who saw that coming?
Why is she going to the hospital?
I don't
she
know.
Hurt herself trying to program it, the poor thing?
Hurt her finger.
Did she break a finger now?
The poor girl.
Oh, my God. I just busted the board here,
put it back,
too.
Please.
Oops. I don't know.
What happened to the button?
I don't know.
Now you're going to have to press it to put that back on.
All right, let me try this.
Yeah. Why don't you press it?
Okay. No.
Oh, great.
The little red light thing, the red thing came off the top. It looks like...
Could Mars help out with that, or is he...
Put a watermelon Jolly Rancher back on it.
All right, hold on. All right, let me try this.
Here you go.
Did it work?
Sage message. Wednesday, February 7th, 9:40 p.m.
Hey, I just want to tell you, you know what? I am, I'm fine. Don't worry about me. You obviously haven't been. So, you go live your life, all right? I'll be fine, and I am, I'm out of here in a big way. Like, out of here. Okay, goodbye.
Wow, all right. So it starts with, like, you know, just call me because we're having some problems. I think we can work that out. That tack didn't work. So then she goes with the, I have a problem with my cell phone. That didn't work. Then she's got the whole, you know, medical emergency
going
thing.
Going to the hospital.
And now it sounds like she's like, God, don't even worry about it. I'm just going to kill myself.
Look, I'm fine. Don't need you. I'm done with you.
Unbelievable.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 7th, 9:41 p.m.
Oh, and by the way, I just realized, you know, if you're worried about me doing anything crazy, I'm not going to because I value my life too much.
Don't worry,
I would never kill myself, especially over you. Oof. So I'll be fine. Okay? Goodbye.
Ah, see? Right. I thought she was threatening suicide, but
that is to put in his head, oh, she might kill herself.
Whenever you have to call someone and go, by the way, I won't be killing myself, that's a rough relationship end.
Yeah.
You're unstable. If you have to actually tell someone that, look, I know you think I'm going to kill myself, well, you can forget it.
Not over you.
Maybe message. Over the phone. Wednesday, February 7th, 9:53 p.m.
Well, you know, I just don't understand how you could be so mean, but I guess if you could be this mean right now, you'll be even worse if we were ever to be married. And it's a good thing I'm learning this now, because you sure don't have any soft spot in your heart.
I'm trying.
You know what?
To
I'm
use
your
that
way.
Sound.
And I can honestly say I don't hate a lot of people, but I hate you. Because you know what? You've tortured me.
Oh boy, here we go.
And you've made me feel like shit. And you've said it verbally. You know, I never professed to be perfect, Mark, but you know what? I would never tell you that I don't want to be with you. I would never do things without you and run away and tell you I don't feel the same way anymore and I don't care. And you know what? You've pretty much done it all. So I guess this is what you wanted. I guess you want me to hate you. So you've made it pretty easy. And you are the one person that I've had here that I really, truly thought cared about me. But what I've learned recently, it's very conditional. It's all conditional with you. You know what? Unless I'm the perfect girlfriend, you got a problem with it. And I hate you for it because you've tortured me. And
no,
I've told you all along that the only thing I wanted to do was work this out. And I knew I was wrong. But you know what? I guess you got a problem with the fact that, you know, I would want you to admit you're wrong. I don't even know what the fuck I'm saying. I don't even know why I'm wasting my breath on you. Someone who doesn't give a flying shit about me. So, you know what? I hope this is how you wanted this to end up. It's a pretty good scene, isn't it?
Why, you little baby!
Take
you
care.
Make me want to vomit!
You at best unfuck yourself, or I will unscrew your head and check down your neck.
Your neck.
Do we have time for more? I can't get enough of these things.
I haven't
heard these in years. What, we have more than 2 minutes? We're running out of show? This one's like 2.5 minutes long.
We can't make that.
All right, if we start now, we could get this in.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 7th, 9:57 p.m.
Oh, and by the way, regarding the phone, don't worry about it. I'll try to wait, you know, a half an hour on your customer service 800 number, and maybe someone will try to explain it to me.
Well,
and don't worry, I won't call your boss or your boss's boss, because, you know, they already think I'm an idiot.
He works for the phone company.
You know, I guess I won't go there either. So, you know, I hope you feel good in the fact that you screwed me with this phone. And, yeah, I'm stuck with it in a $200 bill, I guess, huh? So, I guess I'll have to figure it out.
Well, any fucking time, sweetheart!
I just want to say thanks. Thanks for helping me. And you don't know... You know I don't know anything about these stupid phones, and I've been asking you for days now to show this to me. And, I guess I'm going to be screwed.
Don't
that
hold
over
my fucking hand over there. I said choke yourself.
You. I'm screwed.
How choke yourself?
Every fucking risk I take with you, every time I figure, okay, let's do something that makes a statement that I trust you, I always get burned. So, whatever. And I know your entire office thinks I'm an idiot right now, so, well, that's cool.
The whole country.
Right. Maybe they're reconfirming to you that you don't need to be with me. And maybe you don't even need to feel bad about any of this. Maybe it was a big fucking mistake in your life. And, whatever. But don't worry about me. I just know that I fucking hate you. I hate you. Because I gave you my heart and more. I gave you my trust, even when you broke it. I gave you my trust and my insecurities and everything. And you continued to just take advantage of that, even to right now. So, you sleep good tonight, okay? Goodbye.
The saga will continue tomorrow. That's only 10 of about 50.
Wow.
We're going to have to pepper them in for the rest of the week here.
I wonder if they ever got back together.
Yeah. I wonder what the backstory is to that one. Tony from Cleveland, what's up?
Hey, man, you guys got to stop playing this. You're killing Bob Kelly.
You hear how she sounds?
Oh, that fat idiot threw up yesterday, too. He ate bad pork. I go to his house and he's sweating. I go to the bathroom and he vomits after he ate week-old pork. Ugh. Just laying on a bed with a fucking gimp leg.
With his big swollen knee.
Eating week-old pork.
All right, Pinchy, what did you learn on the Opie and Anthony show today?
Hey, boys, how you doing?
Hey, real fast.
Hey, whenever you say it's your loss, it's really not your loss.
Absolutely. Yep, absolutely. We promised some Psycho Ex-Girlfriend phone calls.
Oh, love them.
Just going to move on a little bit.
What number were we on when...
we're up to... we did 10 so far out of 50. Mm-hmm. You want to explain this to Bobby there?
This is a girl who a guy and a girl broke up, and he recorded all these psychotic messages she left him after they broke up, and he put them on the internet, and there was 50 of them, and she is a crazy bitch.
She's a little needy, a little sad.
A little?
If you want to reach out and hold Jimmy's hand during some of these calls.
I'm sure you're going to get all worked up.
A lot of people said that you'd probably be crying if you heard these.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're very sad. I guess she worked for he worked for a phone company. She had a problem with the phone.
Yeah,
I'm trying to get everyone up to speed here.
Only if her voice is high, like squeaky like helium. Like a little midget.
And she keeps saying how she's done with him, but she keeps calling back.
Yeah.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:08 p.m.
You know, as if I should even assume. I'm assuming you don't give a shit about me. And I'm assuming that since you're not taking my calls anymore, and I hurt myself, and you don't give a flying shit, and from everything you told me today, and how you're not willing to work things out, and how you just, you know, how you feel in general, you just don't want to be with me anymore. But you know what? This is up and down. I mean, every couple days, you know, this is what happens with you. It's a roller coaster, and it's fucking torturing me. It's killing me, and maybe it's doing the same to you, but you don't show it as well. And I pretty much need to know. So, because I'm seriously, I'm sure you can realize that I'm going through a hard time. Maybe you don't care, but you probably are aware of it. And I need to make a change in my life, big time. And obviously I have a thing here. I thought I had you, but I don't have that. So if I'm wrong, I would really like you to call me or stop over or do something, like, really impulsive, because you know what? I'm pretty much at the bottom of my barrel, and, you know, I've had a lot of patience going back and forth with this and, you know, continuing to chase after you. But you know what, Mark? So many times you chase after someone, you pretty much can't do it anymore.
Here she goes.
And I guess what you're telling me is, yes, you don't want this anymore, and I can respect that, but I need to leave, because this is just not working out for me here, and I thought you and I were working out, but we're not, and I don't have anything else here, and I'm not saying this for any other reason but the truth. I've talked to someone in Allentown I could get a job for a while, and I don't want to go, but I know that you don't care, and you don't want to be with me, and you treat me like shit. And
she fucked someone?
That's why I guess suing me. Suing me for even making this yet another phone call. Yet another phone call. What the hell am I doing? Man, something is seriously wrong with me. All right, I gotta go. Bye.
Wow, she's trying everything. She hinted at suicide yesterday.
Yeah.
And then said, oh, thanks for calling. I'm fine. No yeah. thanks to you, because you didn't call me. You didn't show any concern there. Now she's using the tact that, look, I'm leaving. I'm going to Allentown for this job.
I'm moving on.
So if you want me, we got to figure this out now.
Mm-hmm. Do you guys hear? I don't know if you guys got the mass email. It was actually pretty cool. Eric Logan sent out an ask me email about these tapes, and he said that she's having a tough time with the breakup. That might have been better if I didn't say he sent out an ass email.
An ass email.
He did say that. Where is Elo? Why doesn't he call us
very
anymore?
Very busy.
All right. You want to hear another one there, Bob? That one was tame. I mean, they get better.
Yeah, that was kind of creepy, though.
There's 50 of these.
I've gotten for call that really creepy.
Yeah, that's the kind of the call that I think every guy has gotten at some point in his life.
That's creepy. That's
also the kind of call every guy's made at some point in their life.
Sure. That's fucking creepy, man.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10, 19 p.m.
You know, you're making me go out of my mind. Oh. And I'm not kidding. Oh. I'm not kidding. I can't handle this like you can. I'm begging you, as a human being, to please call me back.
Oh, man.
Please call me back.
Yeah.
Please call me back. I'm not doing well. Please call me back. You know, as a human being, please, as someone who once cared about me, can you please call me back? Please.
Well,
to replay the message, press 1.
I'm trying to use the phone.
Ring, 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 banana phone. Ring, 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 banana phone.
Hey, we got Sally.
Wow.
We got a woman on the line. Sally from Illinois, what's up?
I'd like to apologize for the whole female sex.
Yeah.
God, these are, you know, I want to slap her. You know, like that woman did on the airplane, in the movie Airplane, when she slapped that
big
other
line
person.
Of people waiting to smack her in the face.
Oh, my God, and she says the same. Yeah. If from one human being to another, I don't think she's human. There's something wrong.
Well, you know, Sally, it was like your brother Davey once said, you have to treat people with a lot of love and respect.
Oh, yeah. But you have to call me back.
What the?
Awful.
All right, thank you, Sally. Very good call from Sally. Want to do another one here?
Yeah.
We'll only do five today.
Do you have one with a gunshot in the background?
That would be a perfect ending to this bit.
Mark.
Yeah.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10, 23 p.m.
Hey, Mark, you know, I just want to tell you, I've never been like this before, so I don't think it's all me. I think you're kind of helping it along, and I'm going to call my mother soon. I know she's sleeping and she's sick. That is 11:23. And I'm going to ask her to call you. Because I keep telling her that you're gonna take care of me.
Okay, terrific.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. And I don't want to do that. Anybody else here?
I meant to do that.
So can you please call me back?
Okay.
How can you be so cold to me?
No, you are. But
even
what am
if I? We fight, I've told you I love you more than anything. More than anything in this world.
Well,
I just need a friend right now.
Your eyes are getting glassy.
I'm dying.
every time she calls back, someone else is sick. My little cousin tore his ACL. And he, why can't you help us out? My uncle has hemorrhoids, and you're not calling back.
I thought we were two human beings. I have to deal with this all by myself. My friend Bob ate bad pork and threw up, and I have to deal with it all by myself.
He told him about that.
Oh,
you're not.
Yeah, he was telling us about you throwing up because of bad pork.
You ate old pork.
Weak old pork. Lazy ass with a fucking busted dimple egg eating weak old pork alone in an apartment.
I didn't want to go to the ATM to get money to get new food. So the pork was in there.
Yeah, pork is safe when you leave it out.
Yeah.
Past
if there's little white bugs on it, can eat it. Why can't I?
It wasn't the pork that got me sick. It was the sauce that was on the pork.
I thought it was your house guest at the time.
No, he had pork, and after a morning of cigarettes and coffee and pork, five dumps a day and throwing up, your body can't get rid of that shit fast enough.
It's got to come out of every hole.
And I was just sweating. I was hot and cold, sweating. I turned pale white. And stupid Jimmy's like, come on, I want to go get a friggin' a latte. I want to go get a soy latte. Let's go, stupid. And I'm like, dude, I think there's something wrong.
I'm going to puke.
Then I had a hobble, but I couldn't puke because I almost had to get naked to puke because my knee wouldn't bend.
You can't kneel.
I looked like a friggin' ballerina because I was on one knee with this leg sticking straight out, puking.
He was doing this.
Balancing on my forehead.
You know that breathing
you're
doing?
Oh, the breathing, the pre-puke breathing. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, uncomfortable walk to the bathroom. Yeah, it was brutal.
Ugh. I don't think I've ever thrown up for any other reason besides drinking.
God, you're lucky.
I've never thrown up for being sick never thrown up from something I ate. It's only from drinking.
You ever had like a hand hold the back of your head and push it down too far?
My classic story.
No such thing as too far, Jimmy.
My classic story. I was going to the ocean, whatever, on Long Island, and we went to the deli beforehand, and I got a nice, like, ham and cheese sandwich with mayo.
Yeah.
I swear to you, it was at least 90 degrees out.
Oh.
And a little thing of potato salad to the beach, thinking nothing of it.
Good beach food, you idiot. Doritos and beer.
Eventually got to the lunch when I got a little hungry, ate the whole thing, the potato salad and the ham and cheese with the freaking mayonnaise. And then I was supposed to go, I had to go all the way out east, and my brother invited me over for dinner, and he was making, like, homemade crab cakes and stuff. I spent the entire night in the bathroom puking and shitting at the same time.
That's rough when you got a pinwheel on the bowl.
It got to the point we
it's a tough situation.
It got so bad that not only was I dry heaving because everything was out of me, but my body was so sick. I swear to you, I was still shitting, but nothing was coming out. I was dry heaving from my butt. It's a true story. Like, the muscles were still going, but nothing was coming out anymore. That's how sick I got.
Dry heaving from his asshole.
Oh, I swear to you.
When it's just complete liquid.
It's all just muscle control, just trying to shove shit out of you.
Like a Selma fire hose coming out your ass.
And my... And it was my brother and his, like, new wife at the time, and, you know, still kind of getting to know her and all, you know? And she's like, is he ever coming out of the bathroom?
Oh, no.
Dude, I couldn't even make it to the car with you know, some action happening.
Ugh.
Oh, it was the worst. We got time for two more of these calls today, and then we'll move on? All right.
Sage message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:25 p.m.
Dear God, I'm just praying. Please. Please at least be a friend to me. Please.
Okay.
Please. I'm praying to God that you will. Please just be a friend to me. Please. Cool. Why do you have to be so cruel to me?
Hello, exactly.
Nothing else.
You can act like a man. What's the matter with you?
Wow, she is distraught.
I can't get enough of these calls.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:28 p.m.
Maybe you're meeting another chick right now. Oh, boy.
Now
when the turn comes.
She turned again. All right, why am I crying? Fuck this guy.
Well, let me tell you what I'm going to do. Right.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:28 p.m.
Maybe you're meeting another chick right now. Maybe that's why you can't take these calls or check any more voicemails, huh? All I know is I wouldn't wish this on anyone. And you know, Mark, despite the fact that we didn't get along, I don't know why you had to do this to me. And I don't hate you. I love you. Why did you have to do this to me? I don't understand.
Someone check Bob. I think you got some teary eyeballs, man.
No, dude, I'm actually remembering. I've gotten these fucking phone calls, man, and your balls sink to you.
How about on the mic there, bud?
Yeah, how about the rest of the country listeners instead of, you know, us three?
In my living room. Guys, you know, thanks for coming over. I'm glad. Thanks for the bun cake there, Opie. I appreciate that.
Jesus. Try the pork.
Would you guys like some pork?
Some pork.
And some sauce?
I wasn't even in the fridge. He had it in his pants pocket.
This is just crazy. I mean, I'm remembering phone calls I got, man. And you know what? It is funny, but you know this shit. And you know what? This guy's probably done this a million times. This girl gives a fantastic head or something.
Yeah.
Because you know he went back, said this bitch is nuts. I gotta get away, but went back. This bitch is and now he's finally like, fuck this bitch.
You can't dump her though.
And now she's got something's wrong with her.
Should we do one more or should we just call?
I gotta pee badly.
You gotta pee?
Yeah. You want to do one more? We'll do one more.
I'd love to hear.
Oh, let's do another.
What would you love to hear, Ant?
I'd love to hear another.
One more? Okay.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:39 p.m.
I would really like you to call me tonight. It's now 10:37 and there's not much time left, and this night is fucked, and our relationship is fucked, because you don't want to make it work, and, I know, it's fucked for a lot of other reasons, right? But in any event, I have a ticket on hold for Friday to go back to Allentown, and I'm going to tell my boss that I can't make it next week for this training because I have a family crisis, and honestly, I can't do this anymore, Mark. I'm not fucking around. I need to know that you care about me and that this isn't just one of your, you know, valleys, and that you're going to come apologizing in a day or two or maybe a couple days, and you're going to be feeling bad and feeling like you miss me and feeling sorry for everything. I love you, and I need to know that you love me. I gotta get out of here. I can't stand it anymore. I don't want to be alone anymore. And this is the risk of losing my job and losing everything. What do I got here? Nothing. A fucking lease that I'm gonna have to break. I can't do it anymore. And I know you checked your messages, so please call me back. Please. I don't want to have to leave, but I have nothing here. In other words, I don't want to have to leave you, but you're not even fucking returning my phone calls. Please call me back.
The old Scott Peterson solution.
These calls are addicting. Can we play one more before we take a break? I only want to play a few today, but...
Sage message.
This is a short
Wednesday,
one.
Okay. February 7th, 10:42 p.m.
Okay, well, it's done. I'm out of here. And I know you checked all your
few godforsaken voicemails I've left you. I called you I don't know how many times again tonight. And, well, I guess that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter that I'm going back, so I just thought I'd fill you in. Well, you have a good life, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one, maybe. Bye.
All right, she's out. Is
she's
that a
done.
Good? That's
she's
a good place.
Empowered herself. She's moved on. How many more calls are there?
32.
I just got to do the math. 32 to go.
All right, she's done. She's moved on. But there's 30 more. Yeah, 32 more calls.
Yeah, but that was the convincing call. She's done. Yeah, hey, done. I'm out of here. Good luck. We'll meet in another life.
She had some taken off or whatever, but through a quarter or whatever. There's actually more than that. Yeah. More than 50.
Yeah.
Oh, should we stop there? Because she's done.
Yeah, she's done.
We'll pick up tomorrow,
that's
I guess.
Good.
I have a question to an opinion.
Yeah.
I was going to go out to dinner with a young lady last night who I've liked for a long time. And in the afternoon, she text messages me and says, can't make it, had a relative come in from out of town. Mm. Is that a bad sign?
Good Lord. Yeah, that's...
Text message.
Okay, terrific.
Yeah, that's not a good sign.
That's not a good sign at all.
Not even a message, phone call, a text.
Who came in?
Sister. Close relative.
Hmm. Yeah, but see.
I get it, believe me.
Oh, okay.
I know.
I don't have to explain, right?
Hey, look, I'd love to sleep, like, but maybe we can meet for all this can meet for a drink or dessert or something real quick.
A quote, close relative. You know when they're coming in advance. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
to say.
They don't just drop it.
I don't have
usually.
A sister or brother that ever just surprises me and says, hey, guess what? I'm two blocks away.
How you doing?
But if anybody out there wonders why I do what I do, it's this is why.
Yeah.
Every time you try to be a person, you try to be nice, you try to be... this is what happens. So don't question, just be nice, get a nice girl. There are none.
Did you get a nice girl? Settle down.
Get a nice girl every night, Ma.
Wow, a text message? And you were all set? You were probably all showered up?
I know. I was on my way to get my car washed.
Because you were going to pick her up?
Well, it didn't matter. I then drove her. Get the old car, get the old Saturn cleaned.
You're whistling a nice little tune in your head, like all happy. It's spring. The birds are out.
I threw my piss cup away.
What a beautiful day.
Right.
Oh,
that's awful.
Text message.
Message. Oh, I really loathe life.
Yeah.
I just loathe it.
I'm Anthony.
You got to get the hooker, right?
Dude, it's just, what it is.
Did you get the hooker last night?
Of course I did.
Of course he did. He goes from, it's going to be a nice little evening with a real girl.
I'm part of normal society for once.
He's going to be like a real human being for a night, and then it's back to...
And knowing you couldn't just get a regular hooker. It had to be a dirty one, right?
No, it was actually a decent, whatever.
Middle of the road.
Uneventful.
Uneventful.
Meaningless, forgetting what's going on experience. You know, you can't be nice, man. Honest to God, you can't fucking be a person.
What were you doing that was nice?
I mean, like, you can't look at somebody nicely. You can't...
He's been working this girl for a little while.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've known her for a long time.
You can
see
really?
You can see it on his face. He was thinking that this could be a cool little thing that might, who knows, might lead to something.
Jimmy Robinson had a point.
nobody likes Jimmy Norton.
I was just so... It was. It's not even upsetting. It's more like, it's a confirmation of everything you know.
Yeah.
You know, it's like...
It happens too much to be upsetting. You're too used to it. It's just here we go again.
And it's not even about getting laid or sex. I'm not talking about that. You know, it's like this time we just want to go out and be whatever.
No, you were going to go on a real date.
Or just a dinner. I don't know if it would have been a date or whatever, but it would have been
a
nice time.
That's a date if you're going
to
dinner with some girl?
With a girl. That's considered a date.
If you're friends with somebody, though, it depends if both people think it's a date. Like, I didn't know if she would consider it that, so I didn't, because she might just be considered, this is a friend of mine.
Yeah.
You don't know.
You know she got together with her friends, and that's what they decided.
Oh,
the
boy.
Easy way to let you down.
I know. I completely know.
Just text message him.
Can I really...
Say that a family is coming.
I know.
Hey, Corey, what's up?
How much? How's it going today, guys?
We're doing well.
I was wondering if Jimmy left that girl about 50 messages last night.
I will not be ignored.
Look, I understand if you you don't want to see me, but you could be like a real person.
I said, look, this is the gymster. I mean, I don't really care about you either way. I swear to God, no, I don't leave messages. I don't ever.
You're not all that.
I thought to myself, and it was just a fleeting thought, but it's her loss, and then I remembered what we talked about. It did hit. That does hit you, though.
When you say it's your loss,
it's not.
It isn't.
But you never vocalize it, but it did hit me for a second. Like, yeah, her loss. They
You're thinking, you know, because you start thinking, she could be hanging out with a guy with a good personality, she'll have some fun with Jimmy, and it's her loss if she doesn't want to, oh, my God, I just said it's her loss.
Yeah, just hit me. So that, it was gone that fast, and I realized what an ass I am. But it's like, what do you got to do? To you know what? Every time I like a girl, it's like some inaccessible person.
Are you aiming high?
No. I mean, she's a very attractive girl, but
yeah, no, she's cool, man.
Yeah, it's
she's
not
definitely
like,
a cool girl.
It's not like she's some stripper or somebody who's like you know got like a million issues with you know what? But it's not like that.
And you asked her to just go out to dinner. You said
I know her for a long time, mm-hmm. and it's like lately we've been talking more, and like, you know just a little bit of stuff. Nothing major, just lately. Like, uh-huh. you know how you kind of sense, like, all right, we're talking more.
Yeah.
And, but, like, when you realize you're the one making all the effort to, like, get together,
oh,
it's
boy.
Like, what the fuck am I doing? Just spend the money. That's what you do.
Oh, man. But when you asked her, did it sound like she was really into going out with you for a night?
Yeah, you don't know. I mean, who knows? Every time I make a judgment like that, it's wrong. Every time.
Maybe it's not. Maybe you just kind of see things like that. Maybe you're so used to it and thinking you're so, like, not worthy of this type of relationship that all of a sudden, the second something even seems a little off, you go, wow, see, here, there it goes again.
I know I have that propensity for negative thinking, but there are times where you got to be dumb not to see it. I mean, we're pretty perceptive with that stuff, and you got to be dumb not to see it.
Because this seems like an odd situation. Like, you have been talking with her. You get along well. You've known each other for a while. It doesn't seem like one of those girls that out of the blue that you kind of just asked out, and now she's making an excuse.
I know, but it does seem like somebody who likes me a lot as a person.
Yeah.
And I know she does. And I know it's genuine. But doesn't really know how to go, look, I really would rather not.
Well, liking you as a person includes going out to dinner.
Understandable, but when somebody knows you like them, then they have a decision to make. Like, well, do I want to put myself in a position where it could be uncomfortable, or do I want to avoid it? I can understand that. So I'm not kicking her, like, yeah, whatever. I'm just a zilch and I know it. I mean, that's, you understand? So I can kind of understand her.
Did she say, you know, we'll get together another time, or...
No, she's left me a text. If you could have left a message, I would have had a little bit more like, all right, well, that's cool.
How old is she?
Almost 26.
And you had definite plans with her, right?
Oh, yeah, a few days ago.
That's
I knew it was going to happen, though, but I did.
Was it last minute? The text message?
Yeah, the afternoon.
Oh, wow. That afternoon.
4:50.
And how far in advance has this been planned?
3 days.
3 days? And then that afternoon.
Yeah, dude, I knew it, though. But I knew something was going to happen.
You know.
I just didn't know. Of course. I always do. People are like, you're so negative. No, I'm not. I'm accurate.
Realistic.
Oh, dude, beyond belief. Beyond belief.
Poor little
That's all right. Whatever.
Jimmy.
I deserve it. Every scumbag move I pulled, no matter what happens to me, I deserve it. But it's still annoying. I mean, I can't knock her. Whatever. She just didn't know how else to get out of it.
Yeah.
But no, it's amazing. I knew it when I made the plans. This won't go.
No.
Absolutely not. It's like when you know Rivera doesn't have it. Uh-huh. You watch the Yankees, you're like, you know what?
They're going to lose this.
It's 3-1. Not good. No outs. You know there's going to be a problem.
Yeah. Yeah.
People are like, you're just negative. No, I've just seen this many times. Mm-hmm. And when his fastball is, when his breaking ball is not cracking, there's problems. Well, that's the way it is here.
Yeah.
All right, I guess we should play a couple Psycho Ex-Girlfriend calls today.
Yep.
This would be a good segue. Where did we leave the Psycho Ex-Girlfriend, Anthony? This
oh
is like
God.
An ongoing soap opera. I guess we left with her pretty much saying she's done. Remember, she's definitely going to move.
It.
This is the last time you're going to hear from me.
I'm
going
done.
Back to Allentown. I'm done. That's it. You don't have to worry about me anymore.
That's it. I'm done.
It's over.
You're lost, pretty much.
Right?
Yeah,
let me see. Oh, it's a shorty. This is where we left off yesterday, just to bring everyone up to speed.
Sage message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:42 p.m.
Okay, well, it's done. I'm out of here. And I know you checked all these godforsaken voicemails I've left you. I called you I don't know how many times again tonight. And, well, I guess that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter that I'm going back, so I just thought I'd fill you in. Well, you have a good life, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one, maybe. Bye.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Have a good life. and they're going to meet maybe in another life. That's right. Okay. So it's obviously over, right, Anthony?
Yeah. Quickly, to go back for a second, though, we actually have we had a microphone in the Saturn.
What?
And, yeah, we had a microphone in Jimmy's car after he got
the
message.
Yeah.
I'm a fucking idiot. I'm a fucking idiot. I'm a fucking idiot. I'm a fucking idiot. Fucking idiot.
Wow, Jimmy, you sounded a little upset.
I don't know what happened. I'm like, do you want to text me on the phone?
Let's calm you down a little bit.
Can I text you?
Can I calm him down, Anthony?
Yeah. Oh, this will make him feel better.
See, everything's okay now, Jimmy.
You don't have to be sad.
That's life, plan change.
Look, he's bobbing his head. Everything's okay now. Oh, we got Jimmy back.
It's all right. It's all good.
The song just makes him happy.
Life is what happens when you're making other plans. Get over here, you.
There you go. That's all it takes. You all right now, Jimmy?
It's only good while the music's on.
Oh, sorry, sorry.
There we are.
Dean, you come and go. But mostly go.
Couldn't even pick up the phone like a decent fucking human being. I think it's almost 10 years. I truly am shit.
There you go. All right, so Psycho Ex-Girlfriend, Anthony.
Yeah.
Let's get a new one on the air here today.
Sage message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:46 p.m.
Oh, and in the meantime, actually, I probably have a date tomorrow night.
Ooh.
So, you know, you don't need to call me because you obviously don't give a shit about me anymore. But I just thought I'd fill you in and let you know that I have a date tomorrow night with that other guy. He's been anxious to see me.
Ugh.
And he called again, by the way. And this time he got me on my cell phone. And he got me. And I told him I couldn't talk. I called him back. And I guess we're going out tomorrow night. So it's a good way to end my stay in Dallas. At least I'll have some good memories. And, you know, at least I'll end it with someone who actually wanted to see me. Imagine that. I'm ill. Interesting, huh? Oh, and you know what? You do need to lose a few pounds. Bye.
Oh, little jab.
She's
little
fighting back now.
She's getting spunky.
And can I tell you, there's nothing worse than, first of all, when someone tries to manipulate you, but someone who's as awful at manipulation as she is, she's just terrible at it. Yeah. I might see this other guy.
Yeah.
Ugh.
I'm going to go. Yep. Going to see another guy. Get some happy memories.
Don't turn around and look right now. God, how old are you? That never works.
Well, one of your girlfriends is on the line here. Rich Voss.
Hey, what's going on?
And to answer your question, you know what it's like when you're out on a date? Nah, not really.
Come on, you do all it. Don't act like, you know, you don't...
No, he got stood up last night.
Not stood up now, but
all right,
second,
I'm sorry.
Second to it.
Yeah.
What happened? She worked things out with her father yesterday afternoon?
What's that?
She worked things out with her father yesterday afternoon. I don't have to get even with anybody. Sorry, Tim. You know how bad that is when a hooker stands you up?
No, the hooker came through, as they always do and will.
Well, who stood you up? Do I know her?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, hey, please, you're doing all right. Once that show comes out...
Yeah, that's it. That's right.
Go from twos to fours. I'm telling you. You're going to do all right.
All right, here's another call from the Psycho Ex-Girlfriend, Anthony.
Sage message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:50 p.m.
Oh, and by the way, since I'm probably going to be moving back, I'm not going to be needing a cell phone. And that actually works out perfect for me because, you know what? I got a cell phone. Part of my deal in signing it was learning how to use it, which was what was promised to me by their trusty account executive, which I didn't get. And you know what? I don't care if they think I'm fucking crazy, but I don't even have a copy of the contract. And you know what? On top of it, someone sold me something and told me they'd teach me how to use it, and they didn't. And they were too busy boozing it up in the bars tonight. So, I really don't want to have to call
Mr. Burns. Mr. Jackass.
But I got the numbers here.
And I'd rather just have you end this amicably and cancel my contract and make sure I'm not billed with any charges. I'm not going to be here anyway. And you know what? You could stick the knife in and turn it and try to screw me, which I'm sure you will. But I will fight it, and I will make it to the point where you don't, you'll wish you didn't fight it. Trust me, because I'm good at these things. And again, I was promised service, okay? That's the only reason I signed the contract. And yes, you know what? I was your girlfriend, and that's why I did sign the contract. And you know what? It was a pretty good deal. But part of the deal was learning how to use a fucking phone, which I don't understand. I don't want to have to learn out of a manual and, you know, take 4 hours out of my day to figure it out and test it. And you couldn't even figure it out last night. I don't even know what my fucking password is for my voicemail. I got a voicemail in there, and I don't know how to access my voicemail, okay? So the service that I was promised was not delivered, and I don't care if you are my fucking boyfriend or not. It wasn't delivered. I don't even have a fucking copy of the contract, okay? So, you know what? Stick the knife in, turn it, screw me for $200 if you feel comfortable doing that, but I will fight it down to the wire. And I will make people know that you were too busy boozing it up in the bars to teach me how to do it. And you didn't give a shit. I've been asking you for days to show me how to do that. And it's not a lie. So there you have it. Goodbye.
Wow. I feel better, by the way.
Why?
I know what happened.
Huh?
She text messaged me because she didn't know how to use her cell phone.
See?
It was a contractual thing.
It could happen.
Thing. Not that I'm a loser piece
it
of shit.
It could happen.
Contractual.
Mm-hmm.
You were boozing it up in the bars, mister.
Boozing it up.
That's like one of those awful general threats. I'll tell the authorities.
The authorities.
I'll go to your superior.
Yeah.
Will you?
She doesn't know how to use her cell phone? That's oh, whatever.
Like the boyfriend's like going to hear this and go, oh my God, she's right. She doesn't have the contract. She's going to call Mr. Marshall.
Mr. Marshall.
Right.
Hamna.
We'll play one more.
Stage message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:54 p.m.
Oh, and by the way, if you don't think I'm going to call
Mr. Jackass
first, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, they put those in?
Yeah, for legal reasons, because I don't know.
Yeah.
That could have been a problem.
Oh, that's a name cover, like the Jerky Boys. When
yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Mr. Bird.
Seems like he's worthless anyway. I will call him, and I've given you every opportunity to call me back. You've ignored countless voicemails that I've given you. Countless. And you know what? You don't give a shit about me. Obviously. To the point where I hurt myself tonight. I was crying my eyes out. I told you that I needed a friend. I told you that I needed someone and I was going to call my mother and you completely avoided that. And you know what? You don't give a flying shit about me. It's pretty damn evident. So you know what? Buckle up, sweetheart, because you're in for a ride. And if you don't think it, I'll do it, trust me, I will.
She's calm today.
I love the fact that he recorded this dumb bitch and put her on the internet. I really love this guy. I love him. Because you have to, I'm sure women have to deal with this too, but when you have to deal with some self-obsessed scumbag ex who's just going to pester you and annoy you, you should humiliate them like that.
Mm-hmm.
Ugh.
Stage message. Wednesday, February 7th, 10:56 p.m.
I just still feel the need to tell you that you are just a worthless fucking piece of crap that I've wasted my life on for 6 months and I believed in.
For 6 months?
Six months.
This is a 6 month relationship?
Wow.
What a kook. I wasted my life on for 6 months.
6 months, and she's lost her mind.
She met when we went back on the air.
Yeah.
And she's this nuts already. Yeah. Wow.
That you would be there for me no matter what. Oh, yeah, Joe, I love you. I'll be there. I'll do anything for you. Well, fuck you. Because you know what? You haven't done shit for me. And you know what? I hope you're fucking happy the way everything worked out. And I hope you fucking save every fucking voicemail that you ever got from me. Because you know what? I do fucking hate you. And you fucking tortured me. You fucking tortured me. You're a fucking piece of shit.
What?
To replay this message.
Now it's getting good. We need another one. The next one's long, though. Should we end with one? We'll do one more here.
Okay.
One more.
All right, because we got John's here. John Cena.
Cena.
John Cena. WWE. Cena. Sorry, John Cena. He's the champion, Anthony. We're going to talk to him in a few minutes here.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 7th, 11:05 p.m.
Good, you're checking all my voicemails right now. Well, check this one. You know, in the final thought before I'm out of here Friday, I wanted to tell you that, Mary and Terry was much more get rid of him. Mary was like, well, you know what, he's a good guy. You know, he probably didn't mean much by it, but if he does it again, don't even go there. And you know what? She was talking about hurting me. And you know what? You hurt me physically that night, which was crossing the line, and you expect me to be the perfect girlfriend. You pushed me to the point where I couldn't walk for 2 weeks. And that certainly put up the flags, didn't it? But, you know, after that, I'm supposed to be loving and understanding. And that was after you broke all the promises that you made to me. So, you know, here we are again. And you hurt me emotionally more than anyone has ever done in my entire life. I just want you to know that. So you've definitely achieved something, big boy. You've hurt me more than anybody ever has. And you know what? You were the one person that I thought would be there for me. Because let me tell you, you're not the easiest person to get along with either, yourself. And I stuck it out with you to the very end, telling you that I wanted to be with you and I wanted to work it out. When, you know what, life sucked. And you tortured me. And you knew all my insecurities and all my weaknesses and you play on them to the point where you went out for drinks tonight. You don't call me back. You don't return my messages. When I'm telling you how desperate I am and how I need someone, you ignore me. And you know what, being ignored is probably the worst thing that you could do to anybody. So, yeah, you hurt me again. And it's probably not fixable at this point. And I know you probably don't care and you don't give a shit about me, but I just want to say that I really had faith in you and I really, really thought you cared about me. And I guess I'm calling you like a mad woman because I really thought that you did. And I find it amazing that you don't. You care so little. And you are the only person I had here, and you are the only reason that I stayed here. Through all this grief and all this trouble and all of my aloneness. And you know what? You capitalized on that when we fought up until the very end. And I'm out of here. So I just hope that you are happy getting rid of me. And you might be tonight, but you know what? I hope in the long run, down the road, as weeks and months go by, I hope you're happy with that, because you know what? I did everything I could. I've called you a million times, not just tonight, but every time this has happened. And there's not much more that a human being can do. And it's fucking sad. I should have never, I don't even know why I would think to put my trust in you or someone like you. And you are a miserable piece of shit in my world, and that's all you've done for me right now is make me bitter and make me upset, and you've tortured me. So you carry on with that, okay? When you check this message, I'm sure you'll still be feeling good and proud. So I just hope that's what you wanted, because that's what you got.
That's it. That's
Should
it.
We play this?
This is number 22. This bitch left 28 more of these.
28.
We're not even halfway there.
28 more.
You got to love her.
Babbling, psycho. Oh.
Did anybody ever find out who this guy is or who she is?
There's been stories all over the internet about this.
Yeah, one is... Well, she names him there.
Matt.
Her name is Joe of some sort, and they're from Dallas.
Yeah.
Matt and Joe.
Some guy emailed me and said he knew the guy Matt and that he was a real dirtbag. And I deleted his email by accident. So if that guy's listening, if he could resend that. Yeah. He swears he has all sorts of info on the guy.
I'd love to know.
Yeah, and then other people say it was a hoax.
Right.
But I've checked into the whole thing, too. You get some people going, oh, it's been exposed as a hoax. There's one guy that said it was a hoax. one guy who has this thing on, well, you look at his name and the domain name registration has a fake street address and phone number. Everybody that has a website doesn't put their real address or phone number in there. You put any street, USA, and then you don't put a real contact number, so you don't have fucking lunatics calling you.
Yeah, who cares?
But people like, oh, it's been exposed as a hoax. No, it hasn't. There's one guy that claimed that he did all this investigating and said it was a hoax. But the guy never came forward and said it was a hoax. The calls, if you ask me, are much too realistic.
No
Skrull
one
would need an Academy Award.
Yes.
You could tell when it's like it has that phony sound to it.
Because she went too far on the phone. She went to, she didn't nothing. It was like all about the phone. That's the type of shit you do when you really want to slice your own throat. She really this is she unless she is, if she's an Oscar winner maybe.
Yeah.
Well, it's Meryl Streep.
There you go.
Doris from Virginia, what's up? Doris.
Hey.
Hello, you.
Hello.
Modern name.
Psycho girlfriend story from Virginia. Maybe
Doris.
The name, maybe the name is wrong.
I'm going out with Doris tonight.
Everyone that's on hold, say hi.
Doesn't sound like any connection there.
No
or
connection.
That is weird. Maybe the phones are messed up.
Are they?
No, let's give it another shot.
Viola?
Viola.
Viola.
Viola and Doris?
Where the hell are we broadcasting to? What's up?
You're broadcasting to somebody that lives in Oklahoma that drives a truck.
Oh, right.
All
on.
I wanted to say was the guy that was had to listen to all these voice messages was probably just hearing blah, 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 blah.
Oh, yeah.
That's what most guys hear.
Well, you're not going to listen to that psychobabble stuff
nah.
for too long.
Exactly. Anyway, I'm punching out.
All right, thank you. We could sneak in a couple more of these psycho ex-girlfriend voicemails before Joe Perry gets here. People
these
can't get enough
great.
Of these things. You want to explain to Lynchy there?
This is some guy took his voicemails that he got from a girlfriend that was breaking up with him, or he broke up with her, and she was a little upset about it and really took it way too far. She wouldn't stop calling, multiple calls on a daily basis.
Yeah.
There's something like 50 of these things.
Yeah.
More
wow.
than 50. And she goes through different phases. Sometimes she's like, all right, well, it's your loss. I'm done with you. And then it's, please, why are you left me? Why crying? So she's a complete psychopath. We love these.
Sweet. So we're going to play another one. All right. Yeah, let's sneak another psycho ex-girlfriend phone call in here. We were explaining to Stephen Lynch how you know, crazy this broad is,
okay.
Jimmy there. So let's go right to it.
Oh, and by the way, they only stayed for 6 months. Yeah. So she's completely insane.
Wow.
Sage message, Thursday, 12 a.m.
Will you just go ahead? Don't call me back. Don't call me back. Because you know what? It's really helping right now. I need you to call me back. It's big. It's a big thing right now. Because you know what? You obviously don't give a shit. And if you don't call me back, it's going to make a big decision in my mind that I'm done. If you can go out and party with your friends, then you know what? You can be upset with me for going out with my boss and my boss of the boss until 11 o'clock at night, but you were out till midnight, fucking hungover, and calling me and can't even talk to me. You know what? We got a bit of a problem. So either you fucking call me back tonight or we are done. And I want my cat. I want my cat Friday night, and you don't have to fucking pick me up because I'll go to the airport by myself, but I want my fucking cat. I'll come to your house, I'll pick the cat up by myself, and hold 9 yards. I'm done. I'm giving you just one night. Not till tomorrow. Tonight. Goodbye.
She played this gag already.
Yeah.
I'm really shocked that she has a cat. You wouldn't expect a girl who's psycho to own
yeah,
50 or 60 cats.
Cat. They never have cats. Oh. This is my cat.
Mm.
You're one of those.
Yep. Let's do another one.
Saved message. Thursday, 12:06 a.m.
You want this to be over? Well, it'll be over pretty quickly because you know what? This is fucking bullshit. You know what?
That really summed it up.
I'm fucking partying with your friends and I have nothing. And then you get upset with me when I stay out till the point where it's actually earlier than I come home when you're home. That is fucking bullshit and I'm the business trip. You are a fucking asshole. And if you think that you can do
tonight. Can you apologize to me, or I want my fucking cat back, and I want you out of my life. I don't care how many fucking tulips you send me, because if you think that you're going to do this to me, and it's not okay for me to do it to you, you got another thing coming. You better, like, wake up to reality, and either you need to call me back and apologize, or we're done. To replay this.
To replay this message.
I don't think he's calling back.
No, I don't think. I like how she's all bummed that he doesn't call back. It's over, and then she starts bitching that if I do certain things that you do in the relationship, you better understand it. And it's over though. Why is she even?
You know what? You want to know something? I could tell you this is all just bullshit.
What? Right. Making zero
you know
points.
You don't call
yeah.
me back.
Yeah.
I'm going to stop bothering you.
I wonder what, running through the guy's mind, the very first message was, I wonder if I should save this.
Yeah.
I wonder. Thank God he did.
Saved message.
Saved message. Thursday, 12:07 a.m.
Nothing is ever stable to you, is it? You know what? You can do it to me, but I can't do it to you. It's amazing. But all I know is, if you don't call me back tonight in the next 5 minutes, I'm done. I'm seriously done. Because you're going to torment me tonight, and I'm not going through another night of being upset and wondering what the fuck is going on. So either you call me back and you tell me that you're sorry for what you did to me, because you know what? I was out tonight. And you know what? You were out last night. Because I didn't have a fucking word to say about it. You better fucking call me back and apologize to me. And you know what? I want my cat back, and I don't want you to hurt her. And I want to fucking go on with my life. If you're not in it, then fine, get out of my way. Goodbye. I'm giving you 5 minutes, and I'm done with you, Mark. Goodbye.
Oh, well.
Mark only
it.
Has 5 minutes.
That's the ultimatum.
I guess that's it.
That's 5 minutes. All he has to do is wait 5 minutes, not call her. And it's done and over with.
Well, the
How
problem...
How many messages are left?
23. They must just be arranging when he's going to drop off the cat.
Maybe that's what the rest of the calls are, the whole cat custody thing.
Sage message, Thursday, 12:33 a.m. You know...
All right, that's past the 5 minutes,
that
by the way.
That is past 5 minutes.
You're listening to the time codes. Duh, but...
You know what? It's kind of like... When you feel fucked up for me, that's what you did to me tonight. You do whatever you want to do with me all the time, Mark, and it always has to be okay, even if I don't like it. And that's what you did to me last night. And you know what? I didn't say a word about not being happy or not wanting you to go or not being okay with it. In fact, all day today and all yesterday, I said I want you to have fun and who are you with and what did you do and... Did you have fun? And that was it. I never said one single negative word, even though it was very difficult for me. And you know what? You never supported me tonight. You didn't support me. You made me feel like shit. And you wonder why I said burn in hell. Because you know what? If you can do that to me, and I can't do that with you, then you can fucking burn in hell. Then what kind of fucking partner are you on Valentine's Day? Yeah, send me tulips. You know what? And you go out and booze it up. Yeah, you go out and do that the night before, but it's not okay for me to do it. Then fuck you. You do it the night before, and it's not okay for me. Fuck you. You can burn it, you know? Because that's how I feel right now. But hey, thanks for the fucking roses. Tulips. Excuse me. And now you're not even fucking taking my calls, so it's a great night. Thanks, Mark. Goodbye. And you know what? I know that I feel good and that I didn't do anything wrong, so you have a good night. Maybe a better day. That's more like it. Bye. I want my cat back, by the way. And if I don't get my cat back, I will do something just as you always do with the police. So how about working something out with me in a reasonable term? Yeah, I get it. I would like to get it back Friday night because it's my cat, and I don't want you to torch me over that.
I thought it was over. What happened? I thought
Shit,
it was
punch
over
me?
In 5 minutes.
I'm watching the time code. She goes, all right, bye. And I see there's 30 seconds left. I'm like, Jesus. Slow to the cradle
Still
there.
Babbling.
She likes to say you know what a lot, too.
Yeah.
She's just in a sea of Percocet and white Zinfandel, you could tell.
You know what? Fuck you. Why did you call me?
Tony, why didn't you call me? Why didn't you call me, Tony?
No, come on, get back in here.
Well, we'll stop there.
You're being stupid.
You can't dream for any other man to fuck me, Mark. Maybe you want to fuck me.
We got 23 to go. All right. We'll have to pick this up on Monday a little
bit.
Yeah. Well, we can play a couple more of these today.
What's that?
Well, the Psycho Ex-Girlfriend voicemails.
Oh, that fits in nicely.
Nice little segue. We'll just do a couple more today. Where do we leave this bitch on Friday?
You could pretty much just say she's crazy, making phone calls to her boyfriend.
Yeah.
I don't know if she was in the it's over, take it easy, I'll never see you again mindset, or the please call me while you're
doing this to me. She was committed to... moving back to Allentown.
Yeah.
Sounds like she was in Texas or something.
Mm-hmm.
And she wants her cat back. That's all
right.
She cares about is her cat.
Her cat, and she's saying that she's going to go out with some guy that asked her out.
Right. So she's just done with this guy, Mark.
Yeah.
That's what she said on Friday. Unfortunately, there's 23 more voicemails to go.
Yeah.
We'll play a couple more here today. Let's go with this one.
Sage message, Thursday, 12:25 a.m.
Mark, you know what? Seriously, I don't know what is up your ass tonight, but it's 11:22 my time, and if I can recall, you weren't even home at this time last night, and I've been calling you now, and you're pissed at me, and you know what? It just isn't fucking fair, so you do whatever you want to do, okay, and you have a good night, because I'm going to, and I want my cat back Friday night when I get into the airport. I'll take a taxi home, I'll get in my car, and I'm assuming by that point it'll probably be close to 9 o'clock, and I want to pick up my cat, and I'm hoping that even if it's going out of your way, I hope you make yourself available to me, because I just want to get my cat, and you can go out for the night, you can do whatever the fuck you want to do, because you know what, I don't care anymore. If you can do this to me, you obviously don't care, you can do anything you want, and then you can do it back to me, and it doesn't matter, so... I just want my cat, and I want to move on. Okay? Goodbye.
All right. Good news, Anthony.
Yeah.
Good news. She seems a lot calmer.
Wants her cat.
I think it's finally hit her that this relationship's over,
mm-hmm.
and she's calm about it. She just wants her cat back.
She's getting realistic about the whole situation.
I feel a lot better about this this broad.
Oh, sure.
Because over the weekend, I was feeling sorry for her because she was losing a little bit last week.
She's moving on.
She's moving on. Let's go to the next one here.
Sage message. Thursday, 8:12 a.m.
Mark, I want to talk to you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. And you know we've talked about this before. I said something stupid, and I didn't mean it. And you know that. And I won't call you anymore. I'm sorry. If anybody can understand, it's you, I would think. I am sorry. And I just think the whole stupid thing again is happening. It's stupid. It's stupid, Mark. Stupid. We want to be together, and you know it's been a rough week. And I'm sorry. On top of it, I do feel bad. I'm sorry, and I know how you feel, and I'm sorry. So if you still don't want to talk to me, that's fine. And you'll get your money, and you'll get some on top of that. And if you could find out a way for me to get my keys back, because I won't even be able to get in my house, that would be great. But I love you, and I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. I didn't mean to disappoint you, and that's the last thing I wanted to do. So I wish you would just think of that and forgive me. I'm sorry. Okay? Bye.
Well, apologetic.
Yeah, all right.
Now she's sorry. Did she say she was sorry?
Yeah, I think so.
Jesus, shut up already.
Alluded to it.
But I like that she's calm in these phone calls today.
Yeah.
I couldn't really handle the
very
crying.
Calm.
The crying.
Why?
The crying ones.
Sage message. Friday, February 16th, 8:57 p.m.
And another thing to your voicemail. You just lied to me. You lied to me so many times. You lied to me about that with her. It's just, it's mind-blowing. Untruthful, dishonest. So, hope you're feeling good about that. Take care.
Uh-oh. She's losing it a little bit.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. You're hearing in her voice.
It's a little shaky.
She's quivering a little bit here, Anthony.
Sage message, Friday, February 16th, 8:59 p.m.
You know, one last thought. And, you know, yes, I am saying this because I'm angry and I want to hurt you back, but it is the truth. I guess this means I could finally have that date with Joe. You know, the one I've been putting off? I saved his number. Bye.
Ooh. Oh.
we got a lot of
interest here.
Apparently, she wants to go see his U2 cover band.
Wow, there's a little tease there, huh?
Yeah.
She saved Joe's number.
Saved message. Saturday, February 17th, 11:45 a.m.
Well, we seem to have a little problem here, you and I. I'm going to need you to call me back real soon because apparently you're stealing things out of my house now. What happened to the crystal decal thing, the heart crystal, the Swarovski crystal that was on my countertop? Did you take that too? That wasn't yours. My brother bought that for me, and now you're stealing things out of my home. So, unless you want me to call the police and tell them that I need you to return the stuff that you stole from my house, however small it might be, it was significant to me, and I want that back. And I don't know how many other things you stole from me. So, we got a little problem here. So, I need you to call me back and return that to me immediately. Because, you know, don't put it past me, Mark. I'm fucking furious. And I've had it with you and your stupid things that you do, and it wasn't yours. You had no right to take that. You know what? Take your fucking gifts if you want them back. But don't take fucking things that don't belong to you. You better call me back.
So far, so good, though.
Yeah, she's holding it together.
Kind of boring today, actually, these calls.
Here's
a short one.
Saturday, February 17th, 11:47 a.m.
I'm fucking around. You better call me back. Because you took stuff out of my house that it's not yours. It doesn't belong to you. And that's something to call the police about, okay? So you better fucking call me back. I'm not fucking around, Mark.
She's starting to threaten
him. Oh, little threats. The cops could be involved. That's a problem.
Sage message. Saturday, February 17th, 11:56 a.m.
No need to call me back. All I can say is there better not be anything else missing from my house, asshole.
That's it, huh?
Yeah, she's going with the quick ones now.
The quick ones.
Thank God, because there's 15 more to go.
Sage message. Saturday, February 17th, 12:15 p.m.
Well, just thought I'd let you know that another good day in my life, after all your misery. Just found out that my father's going into the hospital on Wednesday because he's already been diagnosed with prostate cancer, and he's had cancerous cells removed twice before from surgery, and they found more. So now he's going in, and we never know how bad it is or if it spreads until they go in and operate. So that's Wednesday. So I just hope you fucking leave me alone and don't fuck with me because I've had enough. And by the way, I'm definitely out of here. I'm probably going to give it a couple months, and depending what happens with my dad, I'm leaving, fucking up my life, and continuing to fuck with me. I just want you to leave me alone, because you know what? You never gave a shit about me, and if you did, you wouldn't be treating me this way. You wouldn't continue to break up with me and get back together and break up with me. You never fucking loved me. How could someone who wants to marry me do that to me and continuously break up with me? So just fucking leave me alone. Leave my life. Don't fuck with me.
Is he returning calls?
That's what I was going to say.
Leave me alone.
Absolutely he is. He's still banging, I bet, too.
You think?
Guaranteed, dude. He's still... There's no way, because the thing she's saying...
How would you want any contact with this?
She must be great in bed. Maybe she has a big meat pocket. She's all over the place, this silly goose, isn't she?
Yeah.
The police might be showing up very shortly. I'm going to go see Joe. I'm leaving town. My father's asshole has to be cut out. Right. Did you pick one thing and obsess
on
it?
He's not calling her back at all. No. He's not, because she's trying everything to get this guy to call her.
Yeah.
You know, you have my cat. I'm going to leave. I might go out on a date with Joe.
And he's not calling.
You're stealing stuff from my place. I got to call the police now.
Mm-hmm.
Now my father's sick.
Right.
She just wants a call back from this guy, and he's not biting.
Saved message. Wednesday, February 21st, 9:09 p.m.
All right, let me say this calmly. I don't know what could have possibly upset you today, because I don't think I did anything wrong. I really don't. And I don't know why you're upset with me and why you called me all afternoon when I couldn't even get to my phone calls, let alone check my voicemail. My mother's been calling me all day, and she couldn't reach me. And I guess that's my fault now, you know?
But you yelled at me when I called you to tell you about the phone. You know, that was a problem. So, okay, I can't check my voicemails. I can't take my any calls. That's a problem. But yet I tell you that's a problem. And on top of it, you know, I don't know why you don't want to see me tonight. So, once again, you're running away, you're withholding, and you're pulling back, and you're torturing me. And I don't know why you're doing this to me again. And I expect a phone call back because you said you weren't going to run away. I don't get it, Mark. I didn't do anything wrong. What the hell did I do wrong this time? And yes, my father went home, and they put him, they sent him, he got home, they called the ambulance, and they sent him back to the hospital, and he's not doing well. And, okay, whatever. I don't know what I do to you. I expect a phone call back. To read.
She lost a little bit there.
Huh?
She lost it a little bit there.
What do you mean?
She started getting a little emotional.
Yeah, she's starting to lose it again. Matt from Connecticut. What's up, Matt?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
Hey, wanted to tell you, I like your show, and this is the first time I heard this thing with the crazy ex-girlfriend, but I had one not too long ago that did the same thing. She'd leave 10, 12, 14 messages a night when she knew I wasn't going to be at my phone. And it's just great to hear somebody else. Well, I feel bad that somebody else is going through the same thing. But
yeah, everybody's been through, you know, I think everybody's gone through one of these where you get these calls and your messages are left.
I'll tell you how I finally got rid of her.
Hey, Matt, you know what? When you call a radio show, you got to kind of listen.
Ann was
going to kind of relate to you and say a couple things, and then we were going to end with the big, whoa, how you got rid of her. It would have been a nice little radio phone call.
No, I'm done, sir. Go ahead.
See, but now he's done. He doesn't feel like doing it, and now this phone call is falling apart as we speak.
Ann's feelings are hurt. Oh,
I'm
annoyed.
I'm a little hurt.
See, when you guys call the show, we like to interact with you guys.
You know, Matt, I was just trying to give my point, and you just talked and talked and talked and wouldn't let me get a word in edgewise.
I'm sorry.
Why do you do this? I'm just trying to relate to your story, and you talked over me. Is that asking too much to just want to be able to talk? Matt?
I apologize. I'd like to interact with you.
Fuck you, and I want my cat.
All right, Matt, how did you get rid of your ex?
She was very religious, and which is kind of odd because she was also nuts. But you know, she was always telling me that.
Why is it odd that she's religious and nuts? Have you seen any of these religious people walking around your city?
They're all crazy.
That's true. She was always talking about how she would pray to God to give her the answer and pray to God to tell her what to do. And so finally, she got me on the phone and I couldn't get her off. So I told her. God talked to me, and he told me she should jump out her window.
Ooh.
So, I guess that either offended her or she believed it, because I never heard from her again after that.
You know, when we're looking back at the week of radio shows on Friday, this is going to be the phone call where we all agree was the worst of the week.
Matt's call already on a Monday?
I guarantee.
Matt, you got the worst call of the week, and it's only Monday.
I guarantee
Sorry
no one is
going
to beat Matt's phone call to this program.
Matt.
Sorry about that, man.
No, it's not that bad, Matt. So what happened?
No, shut up,
Jimmy. Don't egg him on, Jimmy.
Let him take his beating and move on, and he'll learn, and he'll get better.
That's right.
The next time he needs to call.
Matt, are you new to the program?
Yeah, I just started listening not too long ago when you guys came on.
All right. See, he's new to the program.
All right.
Yeah, I think Matt did a fine job.
Were you religious growing up, Matt?
Shut up.
Shut up, Jimmy. No, Matt, shut up.
Matt, no, don't.
Don't fall into his clever ruse.
This guy is good. I wanted to know a little bit about you.
Shut up, Jimmy.
Yeah, no, I'm not a religious person.
All right.
My parents tried, but it didn't take.
At least you got rid of her, though, man. Sometimes it's tough, right?
Shut up, Jimmy!
Thank you, Matt.
All right, guys, take it easy.
Hey, Matt?
Let's go to Deidre. Cool. Deidre, what's up?
Hi.
Hey, how are you?
Fine, how are you?
Girl.
Good.
It's a girl.
Hey, I just wanted to ask you guys if you had touched on the fact that all this madness started going down right around Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they broke up for some reason.
Very touching time.
I don't know. I'm trying to figure out the backstory in this relationship. It doesn't sound like it was a It was a long one. It seems like somehow they met because, I don't know, she bought a cell phone from her. But
then they
started from him.
Cohabitating?
Then cohabitating, and then she went to Dallas to be with him because she's from Allentown.
Yeah.
So maybe she went down there for Valentine's Day and it just didn't work out. I don't know.
Well, it's odd that the cat doesn't have a name, too. She wants her cat.
Right.
They just call it cat. And I hate that I love this now because it really grates on my nerves, but I got to hear what happens.
Yeah, it is really annoying.
It's kind of like a soap opera.
Yeah.
You know what? Which woman really annoys me is the one that announces the date at the beginning of every stupid phone call, and she says February. That really irritates me.
I didn't even notice
her
that.
Perfect pronunciation, that dumb operator machine.
Saved message.
Stephanie
Friday,
C.
10:57 p.m.
Perfect.
I kid you not. I'm going to give you a couple minutes to apologize because I don't know if you thought that was funny again, but it wasn't. You fucking validated my feelings. You weren't listening to me. You burst into a cheer, and I'm supposed to just sit there and take it? You asked me what was wrong. I told you. You didn't fucking listen to me. In fact, you wanted to prove to me that you weren't and you didn't care. Well, you did. So unless you need anything else, you better call me back. I'm not fucking around, Mark. I am so done with this.
Oh, she is fucking around. This is 37 yeah. calls we're up to. Do we keep going or what? Or do we...
One more, maybe.
One more?
I'd say so.
Then we have some...
Saved message. Friday, 10:59 p.m. Okay, can you stop being spiteful now and obnoxious? Because if you want this to work, if not, you're not listening to me. You asked me what the problem was. It's on my mind. I told you.
She rubbing the phone on her bush? What's going on here?
You know, I'm just here trying to sand this table. And
they're playing Guess What's in My Mental Institution.
And then you don't listen to me. So why you didn't fucking ask the question? I am truly and sincerely asking you. I'm not going to be begging anymore, Mark. This is bullshit. I'm not going to fucking chase after you. Chase after me. You know what? I'm fucking worth it. So I'm going to expect your call, like, in a few minutes, like one or two. And then I know that it's not really worth it to you. So, goodbye.
I'm going to bet that he doesn't call back.
I would think no.
In a couple minutes.
No phone call.
Now we got to see if he called back.
Saved message. Friday, 11:17 p.m.
You know what? You're a fucking bastard. You've no sensitivity. And you know what? When you do something wrong, you can't handle it. And fuck you. You can fucking make me feel like shit. And you can't fucking feel bad about it. So fuck you. You're not fucking picking up the phone. I'm fucking sick and tired of fucking chasing after you. Fuck you.
All right. We're at the fuck you phase.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Wow. She held it together right up to that point where she gave him a couple of minutes to call back. Apparently, I would say that he didn't call, and she got a little upset.
Eatabullet.com if you want the latest Jim Norton CD, everyone.
Yes.
Hey, speaking of Jim Norton, someone, who came up with this, Eric? The Jim Norton Psycho Ex-Girlfriend remix.
Sent it in.
A listener? Mm-hmm. We got to give these guys credits, though. If people are sending stuff in, we got to get their name so we can give them credit.
Yeah.
Because they're becoming little stars on their own, some of Ooh. These guys. Ooh. They really are, though.
Little stars.
P-Niggity.
P-Niggity.
I know his name now because of the stuff he's sending in.
Exactly.
Chemistry.
Yeah.
Spelled with a K.
Of course.
So, you know, some of these listeners are becoming little stars in their own right. Ooh. Anyway, this kid sent in a remix. It just misses. We were listening just before the show. But we want to play it because I think it could spawn a lot of these. Mm-hmm.
Great idea, but just something in the execution.
Right.
And I can't even really put my finger on it, but it just missed.
I think it was, my opinion was, the idea was good. We're not saying it's awful. I think it was more like just chop, chop. And I'm not saying you got to be Spielberg in the editing room,
right.
But sometimes the editing has got to be a little
choppy.
Tighter,
yeah,
but this guy gets credit because he will start a trend. Yep. I guarantee it. We'll get a bunch of these now because of this guy. Nick and Rob from Long Island. Okay, this is Nick and Rob from Long Island. They took the Psycho Ex-Girlfriend audio and they took audio of Jim Norton And they put this together.
Hi, sweetie.
What the fuck are you doing?
Aw, don't get all angry and yell.
So you really want it to be over? Is that what you want?
Mm-hmm.
I don't understand how you could be so mean.
I'm paranoid and I have issues.
You know what? Have fun with your fucking stubbornness, because I can't deal with it.
Stop with the semantics.
I've given you everything.
Say what you want to say.
I'm done doing this thing with you, chasing you, until the part where you'd exhaust me.
Okay.
All I can say is, if you're out at a fucking bar, when I went to your house, drove by you, you saw me, and you just drove by me.
That's not the way it happened. That's dishonest. It's not the way it happened. It's not the way it happened.
So are you happy? Are you happy?
No, I'm not.
What, do you think the world is going to fucking chase you because you're Mr. Wonderful?
That is so sociopathic, I almost don't know how to respond to it.
Whatever. I hate you. Because you know what? You've tortured me. You've made me feel like shit.
Actually, you might be right.
You know what? You go live your life, all right? I'll be fine, and I am, I'm out of here. Okay.
Whatever.
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 Bye.
Whatever.
Whatever. The end of every argument. Whatever, dude.
Whatever.
Yeah, you're right. I'm wrong.
Jimmy just kept his composure.
It was from me and Ope's argument right. Soundboard, which yeah. was, it's cool, but there was other clips that might have played a little better, and some of the
right.
editing was like...
You know what, though? Weird.
Like it
wasn't awful, though.
Yeah. Like it, you can hear for yourself, that it just misses, yeah. But it's the start of a new bit, yeah. I guarantee it. Because we loved the Pat O'Brien sex tapes, the remixes that everyone came up with.
Mm-hmm.
I think these guys are on to something big time.
Yeah.
So we'll see if anyone else could come up with, you know, some remixes.
Hey, we give them all a try, don't we?
We
some
sure
of them
do.
Don't make it through the first 3 seconds, but we try them all.
Wasn't the one you played before, that, or was that yesterday, that you played like 3 seconds of it and just flung it?
Oh, I forgot what
yesterday.
That was.
Oh.
Yeah, some of this stuff never makes the air. We play a lot of the audio as Ecstasy of Gold is playing.
Yeah.
And I said to the guys in the room, I don't even remember what it was. I'm like, I've been in radio long enough to know this stinks.
This stinks.
After 10 seconds, and I flung it across the room. But whatever.
We got some Psycho X Girlfriend remixes Ooh. To get to. These are starting to slowly but surely make their way into the show. Didn't we play one already? What was that one? We play one already, Eric?
Played the Jimmy Call with the Psycho X Girlfriend.
Oh, yeah, okay. Was it funny? You want to play that again?
I don't remember that one.
I don't remember.
Was it good or did it stink?
This was the first one that came in.
Didn't it just miss? Was this the one that just missed?
We yeah, I think so. Mm-hmm. It's not that long.
Angel. Hi, sweetie.
What the fuck are you doing?
Aw, don't get all angry and yell.
So you really want it to be over? Is that what you want?
Mm-hmm.
I don't understand how you could be so mean.
I'm paranoid and I have issues.
You know what? Have fun with your fucking stubbornness, because I can't deal with it.
Stop with the semantics.
I've given you everything.
Say what you want to say.
I'm done doing this thing with you, chasing you, until the part where you'd exhaust me.
Okay.
All I can say is, if you're out at a fucking bar, when I went to your house, drove by you, you saw me, and you just drove by me.
That's not the way it happened. That's dishonest. It's not the way it happened. It's not the way it happened.
So are you happy? Are you happy?
No, I'm not.
What, do you think the world is going to fucking chase you because you're Mr. Wonderful?
That is so sociopathic, I almost don't know how to respond to it.
Whatever. I hate you. Because you know what? You've tortured me. You've made me feel like shit.
Actually, you might be right.
You know what? You go live your life, all right? I'll be fine, and I am, I'm out of here. Okay?
Whatever.
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 Bye.
That's right. It just
Whatever.
Missed.
But that was a decent one. Yeah, that wasn't bad.
That's not bad. The second
just misses,
listen.
Though.
Yeah, it just misses.
Just slightly because of the editing.
Well, we got a couple new ones in. We'll start with the Rich Voss one because Voss is in studio here. Psycho X Girlfriend remixes.
Ooh, give it a little tap, Ope. There you are.
Here we go.
A little tap.
Hey, what's going on?
If you're at a fucking bar right now, I will never, ever forgive you. Ever.
But yet,
You got to track me down. You're like an ex-girlfriend.
You know what? Seriously, I don't know what is up your ass tonight.
So much fish in my teeth.
Whatever. You better, like, wake up to reality.
Can we tie this in so I don't have to talk through my phone?
You want this to be over? Well, it'll be over pretty quickly. Because you know what? This is fucking bullshit.
I hate to tell you, you're wrong again.
Yeah, you really want to be with me. Thanks for showing me.
Let me tell you something. You can say I slobber, I screw up words, and I'm stupid. All right, I'll go with those. But when it comes to loyalty, Rich Voss is number one.
You know what? You're a fucking bastard.
What's that?
Fuck you.
Yeah, she has nothing.
You are a fucking asshole.
And I'm stupid.
Did you really want it to be over? Is that what you want?
No, I'm not going. Here, talk. I'll talk to them.
What time is it?
But it's 11:22.
You tell me 11 o'clock, you fucking cunt.
I'm done. I am finished with that.
You're a fucking cunt. You're a fucking unappreciative fuckhead.
So I hope you're happy. I hope you're happy being a lonely guy.
You better fucking believe it. Don't waste my fucking time again.
Hey, that's pretty clever.
Those were great.
That came out of nowhere.
You notice how the tone is similar through the calls? He did something which was just perfect for the tone.
See, they're getting a little better. That one was all right.
I forgot about that guy yelling and screaming at his son.
That's how dumb I am. I thought these were actual phone calls. And when Jimmy came on, then I'm going, but it can't be. He doesn't have a girlfriend. And then I just realized they remix this stuff. Oh, boy.
Ask Asa.
Jesus. Jesus, Voss.
My God.
Well, I didn't know the bit because I don't have XM, so I didn't know it.
Well, how do you not have XM with your friends?
Because they're supposed to get...
How do you... Reg,
he was supposed to get XM.
2 months ago.
How do you not have XM?
He doesn't have XM.
No, you're not looking.
How do you not have XM?
Jesus.
The hell has got you all worked up?
Jesus.
Jesus, Jimmy, what's wrong with you?
He has a girl yelling on the phone and he gets a hard-on.
Gee, man.
Well, it's not a full.
You got a Cialis hard-on? Why?
Not a Cialis hard-on.
Just kind of laying there.
Just mocking everybody.
Yeah.
All right, well.
Looks like Ben after he gets out of a cold shower.
Ben's back at work today.
Yes, he is.
Ooh.
Ben has made a return.
Did we ever get an explanation?
Not really.
None?
Not really.
We did. Remember through the door? I was like, oh, okay, that's what I thought.
I would love an explanation.
Well, I think you should demand one. You're the boss.
Yeah.
For Pete's sake.
All right, well, we have another remix here. This is the Raging Bull one.
Ooh.
You went out for drinks tonight. You don't call me back. You don't return my messages.
You don't believe me. You thought I was over there fooling around. Huh? You thought I was fooling around, didn't you? Tell me the truth. I'm going to fool around. That's in your mind.
Since I'm probably going to be moving back, I'm not going to be needing a cell phone. Part of my deal in signing it was learning how to use it.
Bring it over.
Which was what was promised to me by their trustee account executive.
Bring it over.
Which I didn't get.
Bring it over.
And you know what? I don't care if they think I'm fucking crazy, but I don't even have a copy of the contract.
Bring it over here.
And you know what? I want my cat back, and you don't. I don't want you to hurt her.
I'm gonna eat it for lunch. You hear what I'm saying?
You hurt me emotionally more than anyone has ever done.
Who are you, about?
I just don't feel the need to tell you that you are just a worthless fucking piece of crap.
You hear what I said? You don't ever have any disrespect for me. You hear what I said? You hear what I said?
And you fucking tortured me. You fucking tortured me. You're a fucking Jesus
bitch. Shut up, I'm gonna smack you in the face.
Fuck you.
I swear to God, I'm gonna come in there and I'm gonna kill you.
You care so little.
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck your mother!
All right. It's kind of just funny.
It's not bad.
Listen to the clips.
Yeah.
Is anybody else noticing how just amazing that music is?
It's very soothing.
Yeah. Da,
da. All right. There you have it. The latest...
bring it in here.
Psycho Ex-Girlfriend remix.
Bring it over.
Yeah, bring it over.
I'd like to give the guys credit. The listeners can't just be handing this stuff in without getting credit.
I got to give him a lot of credit there, Mikey.
We got to give these guys credit for working hard for the show.
First time, long time. Fuck you, a mother. Yeah, welcome aboard. Ugh, speech lip.
Hey, we got some, you can hang if you want. We're going to do a couple of these Psycho Ex-Girlfriend remixes that are coming in, Anthony.
Yeah, a lot of those
break.
Remixes. A lot of people being very motivated.
You want to, we're getting new listeners every day. You want to explain the Psycho Ex-Girlfriend phone calls really fast
these
first?
Tapes that were on the internet a while back. Mm-hmm. It's a guy, had a girl, they were together for only a few months. And I guess he decided to break up with her. Maybe even just started treating her like crap, trying to get her to break up with him. But obviously the relationship was done with. And she called and left plenty of messages, I think 50 or so,
yeah,
on his phone. He took them, and instead of calling her back and being all nice and sweet like she wanted him to be, he put it on the internet. And we all get to hear it.
Right. And then the listeners have started making remixes. So the remixes have started to come in, Anthony, and so far I'd have to say they're just missing, but still kind of entertaining to listen to. Bill Lumberg remix, Anthony.
Yeah.
From Office Space.
Mm-hmm.
So this came in overnight. It's from Chemistry.
Chemistry did this one?
Chemistry did this one. Take a listen.
So, what's happening?
I'm done doing this thing with you, chasing you, until the part where you exhaust me. Well, you have already.
I wasn't aware.
What the fuck are you doing?
Yeah.
So do you really want it to be over? Is that what you want? Are you going to be a happy boy then?
Yeah. So I guess we should probably go ahead and have a little talk,
Now, I guess so. That's what you told me. So I guess I should just listen to that.
Yeah. If you could just go ahead and make sure you do that from now on, that would be great.
Call me back. You better call me soon, because I'm done chasing you. I can't express this to you enough.
Yeah. So, you know, if you want to, go ahead and...
You know, sometimes you only do this so many times, and then it just becomes fucking old, doesn't it?
Ooh. Yeah. I'm going to have to go ahead and sort of disagree with you there. Yeah.
I'm going to bed, and I am certainly moving on tomorrow morning. Goodbye.
Thanks.
Sage message.
There you have it. It's not bad, right, Ant?
Yeah. I like the Lumberg, but he could have put it together a little better, I think. Not bad.
All right. That was from Chemistry. The next one is from Nick and Rob from Long Island. It's myself and the Psycho Ex-Girlfriend getting together here.
What's up?
Well, we seem to have a little problem here, you and I.
What?
Apparently you're stealing things out of my house now.
Oh, my God.
The heart crystal, the Swarovski crystal that was on my countertop. Did you take that, too?
I did not.
That wasn't yours. My brother bought that for me, and now you're stealing things out of my home.
You're insane.
So, unless you want me to call the police and tell them that I need you to return the thing that you stole from my house, however small it might be, it was significant to me, and I want that back.
You got to calm down a little bit.
And I don't know how many other things you stole from me. So, we got a little problem here.
Whatever.
If you think that you can do this to me, well, you got a fucking other thing coming.
Oh, my God.
You said you weren't going to run away. What the hell did I do wrong this time?
I don't know, dickhead, because I don't know what was going on that day, fuckface.
You were a fucking asshole. Do it to me, but I can't do it to you.
Tough shit.
Nothing is ever stable with you, is it?
Holy shit, are you kidding me?
I just thought I'd let you know that just found out that my father's going into the hospital on Wednesday because he's already been diagnosed with prostate cancer, and he's had cancerous cells removed twice before from surgery, and they found more. So now he's going in, and we never know how bad it is or if it spreads until they go in and operate. So that's Wednesday. So... I just hope you fucking leave me alone and don't fuck with me, because I've had enough.
Who cares?
That one had its moments, no?
I like that one.
It had its moments.
You're laughing.
All right, we got some more Psycho Ex-Girlfriend remixes, Anthony.
Ooh, some remixes. Who do we got today?
Today we got Alan Sniffin.
Oh, okay. That could be fun. We'll put that together. That's clever.
Well,
I hope it works.
Frank TRC.
You know, Steve, we got to give these guys credit. We can't just play their stuff and
give them credit
and make believe that we came up with it. These guys are working hard behind the scenes for the show. You know, listeners, they got a part of this program at this point, and we want to give them credit when they hand in something good. Okay, Anthony, the Psycho Ex-Girlfriend versus Alan Sniffin was done by Ray from Deer Park.
Ray, I hope he did a good job because the premise is very good. Alan Sniffin runs the New York Radio Message Board. He had commented on our situation with Arthur Chien getting fired for our assault on the media. Yeah. So I guess he took those audio comments from his message board and put them together with the Psycho Ex-Girlfriend.
You hurt me emotionally more than anyone has ever done.
And you don't see anything wrong with that? You don't see anything strange about that?
I just don't feel the need to tell you that you are just a worthless fucking piece of crap.
Yeah, well, you know, maybe I am.
So do you really want it to be over? Is that what you want?
You've known me a long time. We've had back and forths before.
You went out for drinks tonight. You don't call me back. You don't return my messages.
No, no, that had nothing to do with it.
I'm done doing this thing with you, chasing you, until the part where you exhaust me.
You created the environment, and I agree with you, but it didn't happen in a vacuum. Come on here, let's get real about what happened. Hey, it's okay to go out there and act like a lunatic. Go ahead.
I've given you everything.
You're so pompous and full of it.
You know what? Have fun with your fucking stubbornness, because I can't deal with it.
Please, by all means, it's okay. You're not a nut.
Whatever. I hate you. Because you know what? You've tortured me. You've made me feel like shit.
Here's the problem. I don't care. Really, I don't. This is what you get.
That's not bad.
That's pretty good.
That was a great one.
That is a pretty good one right there. It made sense back and forth. His voice is all, you know, excited.
Ow. All right, Steve says this one is mediocre, so you want to take a listen?
Which one is it?
Psycho Ex-Girlfriend and American Psycho.
American Psycho? Okay.
It had potential is what Steve is saying.
I'm going to talk. I think, Evelyn, that, we've lost touch.
I don't understand.
My need to engage in homicidal behavior on a massive scale cannot be corrected, but I have no other way to fulfill my needs.
You could be so mean. Since I'm probably going to be moving back, I'm not going to be needing a cell phone.
Yeah, I'm not. Oh, my God. That was who did that?
I don't know.
Who did it?
I don't know. Who just stopped the program?
The bad must also get credit.
What listener stopped the program, Steve?
What listener is responsible for that crap?
For 20 seconds, we'll never have back. And it goes on for another minute and a half.
A minute and a half.
But we're getting smarter. The old days, we would have played the whole
thing. Oh, we'd have played the whole thing. Now, please.
We don't have time to waste with this.
That
might have been sent in anonymously and wisely.
Of course.
Good choice.
I think that was sent in from one of the guys from the Lex and Terry show.
That stunk. I like when on the message board they post it before they send it to us.
Yeah.
So they'll post it and a few people go, oh, that's pretty good or that sucks or something. And then they send it to us. We play it and trash it.
Yeah.
And then the message board just jumps on and trashes the person. So perhaps that one's posted somewhere and we'll find out who it was.
I like the listeners that post their stuff on the message boards.
Yeah.
And then that stuff is never played. I was wondering why our old boss was on Imus. All right, sorry.
Who's your old boss?
Joel Hollander, who absolutely loves us and would love to bring us back to Infinity Broadcasting. Whatever. Sorry about that. Anthony, so they'll post some of their stuff, and you know people start commenting about it, like you just said, and we never play their stuff, and then they get really pissed off. Well, I don't understand why the guys never played it.
Yeah.
Trust me. We know better.
There's a reason. If it's even remotely good, we'll play it.
All right, let's get to the back to the Psycho Ex-Girlfriend remixes, Anthony. We have another one here that features one of our pals, Ron from Ron and Fez, Anthony.
Oh! That's all.
That's all you had on that?
Because I'm reading. I just sound excited about it because it's our pal, Ron. And I go, oh! And then I'm reading, like, instant feedback.
All right, this is from Ass Suck. At Whackbag.
Is that the ass suck?
The ass suck came up with this one.
Hey, buddy.
I don't understand how you could be so mean.
You know, you're as high as Elvis.
You know what? You hurt me physically that night, which was crossing the line, and you expect me to be the perfect girlfriend. You pushed me to the point where I couldn't walk for 2 weeks.
Right now, just to make sure, you and I will never be in the same room together alone. Just so we know. Just to keep me from doing anything horrible.
You hurt me emotionally more than anyone has ever done in my entire life. I just want you to know that.
I'll do it tonight, bitch. I'll do it tonight.
And you tortured me. And you knew all my insecurities and all my weaknesses, and you play on them.
And then I guess when he was unconscious, he raped me. He raped me. I've been raped. And my jaw is broken. I think I'm pregnant. I think I'm pregnant. Abort it. I don't want a criminal baby. Abort it.
Fuck you.
Call here again, and I'll rip that damn phone out of the wall. I'm not playing games with you. I'm not effing playing games.
I hope you're fucking
I'll chase you down the damn street with bitch.
That's not right. Bad. It started awful bad. And got good.
Yeah.
It had some moments there, right?
It ended well.
Yeah. Psycho, you're on Ron and Fez. Hi, Psycho.
Psycho.
Hi, Psycho.